channel. It's your girl Seraphic, and today's topic is 6 things women do that make them undesirable. So before I start, I know what I'm about to say now will offend some of my beautiful elegant ladies, but hear me out. I really care, that's why I want to talk about this. So don't kill the messenger, hear the message, okay? Yes. So today I want to talk about 6 things that women do that make them unfeminine, that make them undesirable to high value men. So number one thing they do is speaking loudly in public or cursing in front of children. There is nothing ladylike in speaking loudly in public, or you have a group of friends, you are the loud one. There is nothing feminine in that at all. So if your friends or if people you hang out with are truly honest with you, you will know that you are the clown in their midst. So don't be that lady among friends that are that is always loud, that is always fighting, that is always cursing, even in front of children. There is nothing feminine in being loud. There is nothing feminine in being cursing in front of kids or in front of people. There is nothing feminine in that. So if you are someone that is so vulgar, always cursing, you don't even care in the presence of who you are doing that. Just try to imagine that you are in the presence of someone that you admire so much that you cannot curse, that you can put yourself together. If it's your mom, your grandmom, a mentor, just all the time imagine that that person is in your midst. This will help you to stop cursing publicly. Even in private, stop cursing. There is nothing feminine in cursing, okay? Just be a lady and talk politely in private and in public. This will help you to attract high value men, not wretched men, because when you are ratchet, you also attract ratchet men. But when you are classy, you talk sophisticated, you also attract people on that level. So please, my ladies, if you are ratchet, cursing, talking loudly in public, please stop it. It's not cool. It's not nice. Okay? The second thing that makes you, my ladies, undesirable is hygiene. Have a good hygiene. If you have a bad hygiene will make you look just pretty on the outside and nasty in the inside. So always check out before you leave your house if you have a bad breath. Smell nice. Change your underwears every three months or every two months. If you can always all the time buy clothes for yourself, why not also buy new underwears? So have good breath, have mint all the time in your purse. After eating fish or garlic, just throw mint already inside your mouth, so that when you are talking to someone in the Uber, when you are talking to someone close to you, that person will not seize their breath until you leave their sight. Please always take care of having mint all the time around you, so that you always, after eating anything you eat, you throw it into your mouth, so you always have a good breath. Okay? Please, my ladies, good breath, good hygiene, eating healthy. Eat more fruits as you are getting older. Eat more fruit and drink a lot of waters. Water will help you always have clean system inside your body. Water purifies every toxin inside of you. So drink a lot of water, eat fruits, a lot of fruits, and eat healthy. Don't all the time eat fast food. Try also to cook at home. Try also to eat healthy. Even if you are eating out, buy healthy food. Don't all the time eat junk. It's not good for your skin. because what we eat we become. If you are eating junk, your skin will not be glowing. You need your skin to be glowing. That's why you have to eat healthy. Eat vegetables. Vegetable make your skin to look healthy. Even your hair, everything about you look healthy if you eat healthy. So my ladies, please, good hygiene, good eating, healthy eating, exercise also if you have time. If you don't have time, walk sometimes. Sometimes leave the elevator, leave the escalator, take the stairs. Walk sometime, exercise your body. This will help you to be in good shape and to smell nice. Because if you are also eating nasty things, it will make you to be smelling nasty. So please, my lady, take care of this. Number third point is, please, my lady, there is nothing feminine in smoking. Yes, it is true. There is nothing feminine in smoking. If you are still smoking, please try to gradually stop it. If you are smoking like one packet, try to smoke half. Next time, try to smoke 10. Next time, try to smoke 5. Try to smoke 1. Anyhow you know you can do it, to stop gradually smoking is a good thing that you have done for yourself. There is nothing feminine in smoking. Smoking makes you look wretched. Smoking makes you look like you are out from the streets. Smoking makes you look cheap. Please, my ladies, don't be offended, but it's the truth. Smoking makes you look like you don't have class, you don't have level. Please stop smoking. There is nothing feminine in smoking, okay? I love you, my beautiful ladies. I love you so much. That's why I'm telling you this. Quit smoking for your health, for your well-being, for your skin. When you smoke, your lips look like you are suffering. And your skin also look like you don't live well. So, but when you try to learn how to stop it, just determine to stop it, then gradually you will. Okay? It's for your own health. Okay? Please. Number fourth tip is practice being not too loud among friends. If you are the one that they are always calling when there is a fight, they will call you. They are using you as a clown. Don't be that clown. So be the one that is sophisticated among your friends. Be the one that they call for advice. Don't be the one they call for fight. Don't be the one they call for if there is any war, they will call. Don't be that one. Be the one that they will call for a good thing, advice. Be the one that they will call if there is promotion. They will call you because you know that you deserve it. Be the one that they will call if there is any good opportunity. Don't be the one they will call for fight, okay? Practice femininity, the way you speak, the way you act, the way you dress. Practice femininity in everything you do. Practice femininity in your approach towards men and women, okay? Don't be too loud. Don't easily get angry. Learn how to manage your emotions. Even when people are trying to provoke you, learn how to be quiet. Okay? Number five tip is dress feminine. When you dress feminine, you will attract high-value men. When you are always wearing cheap clothing, you also attract cheap men. Don't wear pink hair, purple hair, green hair. There is nothing feminine in wearing a green hair. There is high value men will not take you to their high caliber of friends with a green hair, with a pink hair. They won't. So please, if you are someone that like colored hair, you can use a little bit, but not the whole hair green. So if you really want to be sophisticated and high class or high value, there are things you don't do, really. There are things you don't do. There are things you have to learn how not to do them, like wearing green hair or pink hair or purple hair. It doesn't make you look sophisticated. It makes you look childish. Please, my ladies, I am just being honest here with you. Don't wear pink hair or green hair or purple hair, okay? Please, it doesn't look feminine. It doesn't look sophisticated. It looks cheap. Don't wear cheap hair, okay? It must not be that expensive, but at least let it be all black or all brown, but not the whole hair purple or green. Please, it looks childish. High value men don't respect childish kind of dressing or hairstyle. They respect people that looks sophisticated and classy. Okay? Dress feminine. It will help you to attract high value men. Number 6 point and the final point is, don't be a drunkard. Please, my ladies, learn how to drink your limit. You know, there is nothing wrong in taking a couple of glass of wine, but always know your limit. Always know your limit, especially if you're hanging out with someone that you don't know or someone that you are meeting for the first time. Always drink to your limit. Don't be drunk. Being drunk shows a man that you don't have value for yourself. It shows a man that you don't even know your limits. So, and the way men think, if you don't know your limit in drinking, maybe you don't also know your limits with guys. So please, don't give a bad impression. Always drink to your limit, okay? Thank you, my ladies, for watching. Thank you for subscribing. Thank you for liking. Please share this, my video. Share this particular video to anyone that you know that might need to hear this. Send it to them so that they will learn to be high value and take care of themselves. Okay? I love you all, my ladies, as you always know. Thank you for subscribing. Thank you for liking. Thank you for sharing. Until we see again on my next topic. Bye.